Ladies and gentlemen, we are back. It is yet again another vlog here. Matchday vlog by Doop by the River. Today, it is Union versus Toronto FC, and there is no secret right now, the Union are not in tip-top shape, but let's see what happens when El Parcero Philly gets back to the Subaru Park. So today, join me guys, as we're gonna head on over to Chester, Pennsylvania, and watch as the Philadelphian take on Toronto FC. Let's get started, guys. Let's go, guys.
Shot one in the books. Let's keep it moving.
Getting close, guys. Getting close.
All right, well, we have just arrived, ladies and gentlemen, now in Chester, Pennsylvania.
Jordan 4s or Jordan 1s, Rolexes got more than one. My AP costs 31, millimeters 41. Stick, him up with a stick, stick, he drew the shorter one.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's match day. Go Union!
All right, so the lineups are out. A lot of pressure tonight on these 11, as it's going to be the same, pretty much the same exact starting lineup. Not much changes. No young bulls up in here, but listen, we talked about it this week. They can't allow these early goals. That's kind of what's been killing them. We'll see if this defense can stay back, but man, oh man, a lot of pressure on these boys. Please get some goals early, please.
Quick word with my man, my favorite drummer, my drummer Mike. Mike, man, so first off, for 90 minutes, what can we expect from our favorite drummer here?
We got some new toys. We're playing with some ribbon crashers, a little bit of a more trashy sound on the side. You can't miss it. It adds a really nice, like, other texture to it.
I love
it.
It'll
be awesome. It's a freaking time.
What do you think about today? It's a big one, man. We kind of need this right now.
It is. It's a combination of my fans where it could be, like, a lot of pressure or, like, none at all. Because, like, at some players, like, we've had a couple draws, but we want to keep the unbeaten streak at home, you know, but it could be either way, in my opinion.
Prediction?
3-1 Union.
3-1 Union. Give them hell for 90, but okay. Buddy. Let's go.
So I will say, despite it being seeming a little light in here as far as fans go, I've seen some pretty sick jerseys today. I thought they're going to be NATO, some obscure European kits as well. I'd definitely like to see that. It's all about converting the fans. Let's hit our seats.
Alright, 22 minutes into this game, Union are up 1-0. Back and forth, the typical minutes. Your boys are up 3-0. This feels like last year. Dude, how'd you feel right now, man?
I mean, Gazdag scores.
We got the Gazdag.
Sergio scores. Get the Union scored off the set piece.
Yes.
Defense held it up in the first 15 minutes. No
As
goals allowed.
About on the pod, it's correct.
We gotta see what happens. No second half, first 15 minutes here. But hey, 3-0 at halftime. Ale Bedoya trying to make it 4-0 single-handedly. Nah, I feel good.
So we will never speak of a Gazdag goal on the podcast again.
Except for maybe next time. Who knows?
So we're up 3-0. We got 45 minutes left. Like, what do you expect Jim to kind of do here in the second half? It's interesting. He's got options here.
Yeah, honestly, I would think you obviously put in a few subs.
Right.
Play the kids. I think everyone's been shouting for it. It's time. It's time to play the kids. I think he was planning on playing the kids up in New England to save some legs for CCL, especially because New England has turf.
Right.
So maybe that's the play, and you play more of these guys. But I'd like to see him play the kids now and up in New England. So, hey.
Yeah, man, that New England match is going to be big. You still want some respect from those guys. You're up there. They're leading the East right now, so we'll talk more about it on the pod.
Makes sense. Hey.
They really needed to come out here and show some fire, show some life, and I really felt like they did that. And it felt very similar to the way Toronto came into Philadelphia last year. Philadelphia needed that win,
and you know, it kind of, that win really last year kind of separated them to get to the Supporter Shield, that big Five Nothing Thumping. Tonight, kind of similar, where the Union needed a win just because they've been in bad form. They haven't looked like the Philadelphia Union, and three goals, it was impressive. Defense again showed up big. You know, we're talking to Jim Curtin in the press conference this week. You know, he talked about it. Defense has to step up. We can't continue allowing these early conceding goals in these matches, putting the Union in tough situations. The Union are not built to outscore teams, and that's just the fact of the matter. We don't really have that killer per se. We have some good attacking players, as you clearly saw tonight, but the Union have a style and they have to stick to it. And they have to be able to not allow teams to get them out of that comfortability as well. So, good win here. Sergio Santos, again, with another dominating performance here. Leon Flack was all over the pitch. He was so tenacious. This was, to me, one of the better matches from him that we have seen over the last couple of matches. Back line was big. Obviously, Kai Wagner getting the MLS All-Star nod. Really good to see him. He was active. You know, we talked about it in the first half. There was a lot of crosses in the Union. I feel like we're trying to, you know, figure that out, because when it comes to Club America is going to be the most talented club they have faced in the entire 2021 year as a whole. So they got to try to knock those kinks out. Once they got up to that 3-0 lead, it was big. And then they were able to kind of play to their game and kind of calm down a little bit. And the goals, man, one thing is for sure, Sergio Santos has that freaking speed. And of course, you get the corner kick goal by Iglesias, and you also get the Daniel Gazdag PK. Listen, it's his first goal, it's a PK. You take it how you can, right? You're going to take that at however way you can. And for Gazdag, it was a PK. And hopefully that kind of jumpstarts him to being a goal-scoring threat here for the Philadelphia Union. Great match. You kind of got to build from this. Jim said we're coming in here, you're trying to get 3 points, and they did. Now it's a quick turnaround. Sunday, you got New England. You're going to be up in Foxborough to face off against the Revs. That's going to be a tough game. You're talking about the first-place team in the Eastern Conference right now. Carlos Gil is playing like an MVP style of soccer right now. So we'll see what happens there. Make sure you stay tuned to Doop by the River. We'll have you guys covered. I'll try to have this vlog up as soon as possible as well. Definitely by next Wednesday, we'll have this vlog up. Guys, thank you so much for tuning on in. More TikToks today than actual vlogging, but it's all good. We still got some good shots. It was a great night. Not too crowded, but it was still good vibes. Ladies and gentlemen, I go by the name of El Parcero Philly. You guys enjoy the rest of your night.